On behalf of the community elders and the Warrenton Heights Board of Education, I bring greetings to the Warrenton Heights City School District's 2021 Black History Program. As the superintendent of this great school district that is 99% African American, our theme, our relevance in society, is very significant to our journey of educating our scholars to become positive and productive citizens of this community and world. The great Barbara Jordan stated, "We, the people, it is a very eloquent beginning." But when that document was completed on the 17th of September in 1787, I was not included in that "we, the people." I felt somehow for many years that George Washington and Alexander Hamilton just left me out by mistake. But through the process of amendment, interpretation, and court decisions, I have finally been included in "we, the people." An understanding of the successes and failures of the past is important if we are to grow and make progress going forward. If we do not learn from our mistakes, we are bound to repeat them. Our history did not start with slavery, but began with the start of life on this planet. We are the descendants of kings and queens and have made some of the most significant contributions to the world. We created or invented such things as medicine. Many treatments used in modern medicine were first employed in Africa centuries ago. The earliest known surgery was performed in Egypt around 2750 BC. Medical procedures performed in ancient Africa before they were performed in Europe include vaccinations, autopsies, limb traction and broken bone settings, bullet removal, brain surgery, skin grafting, the filling of dental cavities, the installation of false teeth, that what is now known as cesarean sections, anesthesia, and tissue cauterization. Or some of the things we use daily, such as the traffic light by Gary Morgan, the light bulb by Lewis Latimer, the automatic refrigeration system by Frederick McKinley, the home security system by Mary Ann Britton Brown, and the ice cream scooper by Alfred Crail. As I conclude, I hope that you find our program to be educational and enlightening. I also challenge you to continue to learn and grow each day as we navigate in this ever-changing world. As you learn, it is important that we lift as we climb on this journey. Please enjoy the program.
Greetings. My name is Vicki Pruitt-Sorrells, and I have the honor of facilitating this event along with a bodacious crew of teachers and scholars who produce this year's Warrensville Heights City School District Black History Month program. The names of prominent African American leaders and legacy makers have been associated with Black History Month for so many years and for so many reasons. It has been in the spirit of these individuals that has allowed us as a people to move forward and advance in this country. And yet, it has not just been the individuals, but it has been the characteristics that have been displayed that has added depth to the African American experience. This year, our scholars have selected to focus on the significance of our people. The theme for Warrensville Heights City School District History Program for 2021 is Our Relevance in Society. During this production and presentation, you will be exposed to the voices of our young people today. They will articulate and illustrate that their voices matter because their existence matters, because they are relevant and they are significant and they are powerful. Therefore, I invite you to join with us as we hear the voices of our scholars who shout to the world that their vote matters as they have claimed their personal power through organized and peaceful protests, accepting their call to be the change that this world needs while making their ancestors proud. Today, we celebrate the voices of our scholars in their presentation of Our Relevance in Society. Thank you.
Today we are going to be reciting "Hey Black Child" by Eugene Perkins. Hey Black Child, do you know who you are, who you really are? Do you know you can be what you want to be, if you try to be what you can be? Hey, black child, do you know where you're going? Where you really going? Do you know you can learn what you want to learn? If you try to learn what you can learn. Hey, black child, do you know you are strong? I mean, really strong. Do you know you can do what you want to do? If you try to do what you can do. Hey, black child, be what you can be. Learn what you must learn. Do what you can do. And tomorrow, your nation will be what you want it to be.
Black people were denied the right to vote in this country until Congress passed the 15th Amendment on February 26, 1869. It was then ratified on February 3, 1870. This decision granted black men the right to vote in this country. On March 31, 1870, Thomas Mundy Peterson proudly cast his vote in the ballot box. He was the first black man to ever vote in an election. He knew that this was important to do, because for the first time in this country, not only did every vote count, but his vote could help create change to make this country a better place to live for all black people.
This is the best day ever.
Hello, I am Shirley Anita Chisholm. In 1968, I became the first black woman elected to the United States Congress. I also became the first black person to run for president of the United States in 1972. Even though many people did not want me to run, that didn't bother me. Like I always say, if they don't give you a seat at the table, bring a folding chair. And that's what I did. This country still needs change, and I believe that one day we will have a black president help continue make those changes happen. This will only happen if you remember every vote counts.
Hello, I am Reverend Jesse Lewis Jackson. In 1984, I became the second African American after Shirley Chisholm to run president of the United States. Just like Shirley, I ran as a Democrat. I did not win, but that is okay because I am somebody. I may be poor, but I am somebody. I may be a welfare, but I am somebody. I may be uneducated, but I am somebody. I must be. I am God's child. I must be respected and protected. I am black and beautiful. I am somebody so powerful. Because of you, I received millions of votes in 1984. Even though I did not win, I know one day there will be a black president of the United States. Because you count, you matter, and every vote counts.
Hello, I am Barack Obama, this country's first black president. This country needed a big change. Thanks to others like Shirley Chisholm, the Reverend Jesse Jackson, and all of our forefathers, ancestors, and you. Together we made it happen because we knew that change would not come if we wait on some other person or some other time. We are the ones we've been waiting for. We are the change that we seek. Do not let this stop with me. Together we can change the face of America because every vote counts.
Hello, I'm Kamala Harris, the first person of color and female vice president of these United States. But while I may be the first woman in this office, I will not be the last. Because every little girl watching tonight sees that this is a country of possibilities. And to the children of our country, regardless of your gender, our country has sent you a clear message. Dream with ambition, lead with conviction, and see yourselves in a way that others may not simply because they never seen it before. We know now that together we can be the change because we have proved that we matter and every vote counts.
Hi, my name is Alex Lawhan and I'm singing I Will Always Love You.
Our relevance in society means more than just being African American. Our voice and the way we represent ourselves have always been our form of power and protest. Travel through time as we encounter informative circumstances focused on racial injustice and discriminatory practices that led to a form of protest. The America that we know has given roots to form of protest such as sit-ins and marches. Let us embark on a pivotal transition in African American culture by re-witnessing a new voice of power and protest led by prominent leaders of the Black Panther Party that focused on social reform, racial pride, and political justice for African Americans. Lastly, as we encounter the hardships faced in the African American community in the 21st century, we will see how our form of protest has transitioned over the many decades in response to civil injustice.
Hey guys, let's go down to Woolworths to grab a quick bite to eat.
Hey, this looks like a great spot.
You know you can't sit there. You get your meals from around the back.
What do you mean the back? You take our money and treat us like animals of shame?
Yes, the back. If you don't like it, you can go somewhere else.
Man, let's go, guys. But we'll be back. Our voices will be heard, and they won't like what they see.
It's a new day. We're going to sit here until our demands are met. We're sitting in these spots, no violence intended, until someone sees the change that should be made.
You can't sit there. Get up. Unless getting arrested is worth it, huh?
The time is now. We must fight for a new cause and a new belief.
Yeah, my sister, the power belongs to the people. If they can't see our dream, we will make it relevant ourselves.
We have to do for our people what the government won't do. We need to stand up against the police brutality. We need to provide service, food programs. We need to provide free clinics. We need to provide forms of transportation. We need to provide jobs, opportunities, and most importantly, stand up for the oppression.
The new reform won't happen peacefully, but it needs to be done. Power to the people.
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 That could have been me walking from the store getting gunned down by a neighborhood watchman.
Just because I fit the description does not mean I did it. Seriously, my skin should not be considered a weapon, but it is.
When you think about the past 8 years from 2012 to 2020, our people have been getting gunned down by police or civilians. This is not right. I can't sleep at night knowing that the people who sworn to protect us make me nervous during a routine stop, or those that may live or near my community are afraid of me because of my ethnicity.
Yeah, my life matters. It's time we come together to show how our people can stand for a change. The days of the old must be torn down and lifted up with equality and dignity.
My life matters, yours should too. Hashtag be the change.
My name is Adam Williams, and this song is What's Going On.
Mother, mother, there's far too many of you crying. Brother, 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 there's far too many of you dying. You know we got to find a way to bring some love in here today, yeah. Father, father, you don't need to escalate. You see, war is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate. You know we got to find a way to bring some love in here today. And picking lines and picking signs, don't punish me with brutality. Talk to me so you can see, oh, what's going on, what's going on, what's going on, what's going on, oh. What's going on? Yeah, what's going on? Tell me what's going on. I'll tell you what's going on. What's going on? Yeah, what's going on? Tell me what's going on. I'll tell you what's going on.
I am black. 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 James Weldon Johnson, the lyricist of our famous Lift Every Voice and Sing, once wrote, God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, thou who has brought us thus far on the way, thou who has by thy might led us into the light, keep us forever in the path, we pray. It is often said we learn from our past. Malcolm X even said, without education, you're not going anywhere in this world. The past teaches us where we have come from, but also points to where we are headed in the future. As Black Americans, we are a people who are known for being trailblazers in so many facets of life: science, art, poetry, engineering, and yes, even in music, to name a few. In an effort to make our ancestors proud, we look backwards and reflect on the struggle and perseverance they endured, while also looking forward with the same hope and determination shown and instilled within each of us. Those who have gone before us have fought the good fight, peacefully stood for what was right, and have served in a spirit of humility and love. So will you walk in those very footsteps of discomfort and courage? Will you wake up, stand up, speak up, stay woke, and live in order to keep the dream alive? As we listen to the words of these notable trailblazers, may we continue the work of making our ancestors proud.
We wear the mask that grins and lies. It hides our cheeks and shades our eyes. This debt we pay to human guile. With torn and bleeding hearts, we smile and mouth with myriad subtleties. Why should the world be overwise and contain all our tears and sighs? Nay, let them only see us while we wear the mask. We smile, but O great Christ, our cries to thee from tortured souls arise. We sing, but O the clay is vile beneath our feet and long the mile. But let the world dream otherwise. We wear the mask by Paul Laurence Dunbar.
Kamala Harris gives victory speech in Wilmington, Delaware. Good evening. So Congressman John Lewis wrote, democracy is not a state, it is an act. And what he meant was that America's democracy is not guaranteed. It is only as strong as our willingness to fight for it, to guard it, and never take it for granted. And protecting our democracy takes struggle, it takes sacrifice. But there is joy in it, and there is progress, because we the people have the power to build a better future. And when our very democracy was on the ballot of this election, with every soul of America at stake and the world watching, you ushered in a new day for America. To our campaign staff and volunteers, this extraordinary team, thank you for bringing more people than ever before into the democratic process and for making this victory possible. To the poll workers and election officials across our country who have worked tirelessly to make sure every vote is counted, our nation owes you a debt of gratitude as you have protected the integrity of our democracy.
The Hill We Climb by Amanda Gorman. When the day comes, we ask ourselves, where can we find light in this never-ending shade? The loss we carry, a seed we must wave. We brave the belly of the beast. We learned that quiet isn't always peace. And the norms and the notion of what is just is isn't always justice. And yet, the dawn is ours. Before we knew it, somehow we do it. Somehow we weathered and witnessed the nation that isn't broken, but simply unfinished.
We, the successors of a country and a time where a skinny Black girl descended from slaves and raised by a single mother, can dream of becoming president only to find herself reciting for one. And yes, we are far from polished, far from pristine, but that doesn't mean we are striving to form a union that is perfect. We are striving to forge a union with purpose, to compose a country committed to all cultures, colors, characters, and conditions of man. And so we lift our gazes not to what stands between us, but what stands before us.
We close the divide because we know to put our future first. We must first put our differences aside. We lay down our arms so we can reach out our arms to one another. We seek harm to none and harmony for all. Let the globe, if nothing else, say this is true. That even we grieve, we grew. That even as we hurt, we hope. That even as we tired, we tried. That will forever be tied together, victorious. Not because we'll never again know defeat, but because we'll never again sow division.
My name is Treasure Johnson, and I'm singing stand-up.
I've been walking with my face turned to the sun. Weight on my shoulders, a bullet in my gun. Oh, I got eyes in the back of my head, just in case I have to run. I do what I can when I can for my people. While the clouds roll back and the stars fill the night, that's when I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Far across the river, can you hear freedom calling? Calling me to answer, gonna keep on keeping on. I can feel it in my bones. Early in the morning, before the sun begins to shine, we're gonna start moving toward that separating line. I'm wading through muddy waters, you know I got mine. And I don't care if I lose any blood on the way to salvation. And I'll fight with the strength I have until I die. That's when I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Far across the river, can you hear freedom calling? Calling me to answer, gonna keep on keeping on. I can feel it in my bones.
Wow. Well, I can certainly say we have been challenged to stand up and make a difference and be the difference. My name is William Brewer, and I'm the vocal music teacher for the Warrensville Heights Middle and High Schools and a member of the planning committee who helped make this event possible. I hope you enjoyed this year's Black History Month program. Although it was delivered in a different setting, it was nothing short of amazing. Today, we have heard the writings and testimonies of various trailblazers, those rhythms of our past and of our present who have marched to the steady beat of who we are as African Americans, Black Americans, the beat of justice, equality, and perseverance. I am confident that the young people we have heard from today are our future trailblazers and will walk that exact same beat in those exact same footsteps, and in fact, will do even greater. Remember this, every day is Black History Day, and every month is Black History Month. I don't say that lightly, because when you think about it, each morning you wake up, you have another opportunity to make our ancestors proud. You have the power to walk, talk, work, live, and strive for excellence and greatness. With each passing day, you have the opportunity to be the change our community and our country and our world so desperately needs. Minute by minute, hour by hour, day by day, week by week, month by month, and year by year, you must exude greatness. Let your voice and your vote be heard. Do not let anyone tell you that you are less than what you know yourself to be. And do not grow weary in well-doing. So with this in mind, I say thank you to all of the Warrensville Heights City School District scholars and staff who helped to make this first virtual Black History Month program possible. Your hard work, patience, and commitment certainly did not go unnoticed. And on behalf of the Warrensville Heights Board of Education, Superintendent Jolly, district office staff, and all staff and students of this great district, we say thank you for joining us and for your continued support. Stay safe, stay encouraged, and always remember that we are one team, one vision, one goal. Blessings and good day.
Been walking with my face turned to the sun. Weight on my shoulders, a bullet in my gun. Oh, I got eyes in the back of my head. Just in case I have to run, I do what I can when I can for my people. While the clouds roll back and the stars fill the night, that's when I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Far across the river, can you hear freedom calling? Calling me to answer, gonna keep on keeping on. I can feel it in my bones. Early in the morning, before the sun begins to shine, we're gonna start moving toward that separating line. I'm wading through muddy waters. You know I got mine. And I don't care if I lose any blood on the way to salvation. And I'll fight with the strength I have until I die. That's when I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Far across the river, can you hear freedom calling? Calling me to answer, gonna keep on keeping on. I can feel it in my bones.